Hi everybody, my name is Kyle. I run a YouTube channel called Hi Kyle Taggart, where I talk about cameras, photography, tech, and all that good stuff. Today, I want to talk about why cybersecurity is so important. I've been in IT for a little over 10 years now. I have a BS in Management Information Systems, and I've worked in a couple different facets in IT, like law enforcement, doing web server installations. I've worked in store systems in a retail environment. I've done help desk at a university, and I'm currently an incident manager on the IT team for an online bank. So what is cybersecurity? Well, the definition is pretty self-explanatory. It is the protection of our online space from hackers and other cyber criminals. For most of us, cybercrime seems like a pretty far-fetched threat. Just think, how many times have you heard people say they have nothing to hide or who would be interested in their data? For some reason, many users don't treat their online space the same way they treat their physical space. They see cybercrime as something that's less tangible and therefore less dangerous. People use weak passwords like password, please don't use that. People also don't spend an extra penny or two on antivirus software or a VPN. Most of the time, they're just clicking on emails that they haven't even read the title of. So we should protect our cyberspace just like we would protect our physical space, like our house, apartment, or flat. Cybercrime can cause huge damage, impacting our financial, emotional, and social lives. Imagine your Instagram gets hacked, all your photos get deleted, and then all of a sudden you see these scam photos on your Instagram where you used to have pictures of your family, your pet, your breakfast. I know people who've had their social media hacked, and it feels like you're being violated, like your privacy is being invaded. Now imagine that, you know, just photos of your family and things like that, but your bank account and then money being taken and things like that, your identity being stolen. It can get pretty serious pretty quick. So yeah, cybercrime is real and targets not only celebrities and huge corporations, but people like you and me. Even the most mundane data could be valuable to a cybercriminal out there. Just think of how much of your life you spend online. I mean, me personally, I'm tweeting all the time. I'm posting on Instagram, both photos and Instagram stories of like day-to-day stuff. And I post YouTube videos. So I'm online most of the day. Then on top of that, I work remotely, so I'm working online. I shop online for the most part, and I do financial stuff online. Besides all of that, we even communicate with thermostats online, doorbells online, garage door openers. The list goes on and on. That means that there is a ton of data about us out there in the open. What is worse is many apps are interconnected, so by hacking a single account, criminals can then access the rest. A good VPN service adds a strong security layer by encrypting your traffic and hiding your IP. Just think of what you store online: account passwords, personal chats, essential documents and devices, which we carry around and connect to unsafe Wi-Fi networks. You'll probably notice as you look around your house that you have a number of devices that could be hacked, like phones, laptops, even fridges or doorbells. We might not realize it, but something as small as a smart doorbell or lock could potentially lead to someone hacking it and then entering your home. Most of us, and myself included, are connected to social media networks basically 24/7. And we have a lot of apps running in the background that we might not think about. And even a tech giant like Facebook has had cybersecurity incidents. So as you can see, cybersecurity is not a futuristic concept, but an essential part to your everyday life. And let's not forget that as you get more devices, more social networks pop up, that cybercrime is on the rise, and hackers are always looking to exploit cutting-edge technology for their own needs. Every technological advancement is both an opportunity and also a threat. So that may sound a little heavy and a little scary, but that's okay. What we really should do is not let the threat scare us from doing our best to protect our property. So here are a few tips on how you can strengthen your online security. Tip number one for your online security: have a strong password. Think about your online security this way. You have a castle. All of your data, all your stuff, your Instagram posts, your bank account information is inside this castle. Do you want a castle with just a wide open door to all of the things that you value? No. So don't use a password like your first name, 123, and then your birth date. Your password should be complex, it should have symbols in it, it should be something that someone can't guess. If you have a complex password, then you have a castle with a moat in front of it, with ferocious alligators, and then spikes in front of that, and then a giant wall in front of that, so your castle and your information is much more secure. You should also use different passwords for different applications. You shouldn't use the same password everywhere, because then that is more vulnerable for someone to find out one password, and then if it's the same password everywhere, then they have the key to all of your castles. If you have trouble remembering the different passwords that you have, NordVPN has a password manager, so it will help you memorize and store your passwords for you. A VPN is very essential for your online cybersecurity. It will encrypt your traffic and hide your IP, so nobody will be able to tell what you do online or snoop around your data. NordVPN is one of the best VPNs out there. You want to avoid free VPN services. They're very likely to collect your data and share it. The next one seems pretty obvious, and that's use good antivirus software and keep it up to date regularly to have the most up-to-date versions, as they include the most recent malware in their databases. Next is always use common sense when surfing the web. Don't open links or attachments that you get from people that you don't know well. Some scammers can even use your friends' accounts as an avenue to send you malicious links. If you're ever suspicious about a link, especially something that your friend sent, ask them if they sent it to you. If they didn't, then it's probably something that's going to put you at risk. Don't click on dodgy pop-ups or visit unreliably looking websites. If you have any doubts whatsoever, always do a quick search on Google. That'll definitely help you out. Your awareness could help you prevent a social engineering attack when criminals trick users into giving away specific data. They could use something like an interest of yours that is out in the public online, or they could send you a message from a friend's account. Just knowing such techniques as these will make you more careful as you browse the web, and we can see awareness is essential to our safety. Maybe you're visiting a brand new website for the first time, or you just signed up for a service that you've just heard of, or you're using an app that's the new hot thing. Always a good idea to take a look at their security policy before diving in. It's also good to minimize the usage of non-essential apps, websites, or services, which will lessen the amount of data that you give away. So hopefully some of these tips helped you out and helped you better understand cybersecurity and why something like a VPN can help you immensely. All right, guys, that about wraps up this video on the importance of cybersecurity and why you should use a VPN. For more videos on online security, subscribe to NordVPN's YouTube channel. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stay safe.